What's going on, Gamertag Radio crew? Just want to go ahead and say thank you so much for all your guys' hard work, first and foremost. This is Mike, a.k.a. Hungry Bear, all the way in Miami, Florida. And so I just wanted to talk a little bit about Halo. First of all, congratulations on episode 1000. Having Phil in there is going to be pretty awesome. I can't wait for that. It's actually dropping on my birthday. So I know you guys are working really hard over there, so thank you for that. I'm super excited for that episode and can't wait to see what Phil has to say. And I know you guys are going to do an awesome job, and it's going to go get better from here on out. But Paris and Danny, I've been hearing you guys talk a lot about Infinite, or not, just a little bit more than usual. And I completely agree. If Infinite doesn't do great at launch, it's going to hurt the Halo community, it's going to hurt the Xbox community, and it's going to hurt the Xbox brand in general, and the franchise, the Halo franchise. I don't think it'll be put in a good place at all if it doesn't fully execute a perfect launch or a successful launch. You know, we have been talking, hopefully, that one of the things that would be needed is Halo Infinite would launch with everything in-game day one. But my question to you guys is this. What do you think about Halo Infinite being a games as a service? I mean, the name is not there for nothing. There's infinite possibilities. Aaron Greenberg had mentioned a couple of things about there being something added onto Halo Infinite. And so my question to you guys is, what do you think about Halo Infinite as a game, as a service, and how would that be approached by Microsoft? What would be the best way to execute that? Again, thank you so much for your guys' time, and keep it up, man. All right, take care.
Hey, thank you for that voicemail. Truly appreciate it. We've seen him around on social media, part of Discord channel and all that, so we appreciate all the support. Halo Infinite, he's right. This is something that we have definitely been talking a lot about the past few weeks, because obviously we're now in 2020, and we know this is going to be arguably the biggest game that Microsoft has ever made. And he brings up that great point about, is Halo Infinite going to be a game as a service, right? So I think it is. I think that's why it rumored has a $500 million budget right now. I think that's why it is called Halo Infinite. I think that's why the first teaser we saw showed an open world. They're going to go all in with this. It's again, we know nothing about the game, which is so fascinating that we're potentially about 10 months away from it coming out, and we still know nothing. I'm again assuming that E3 is going to be the big reveal for it. I'll pause right there and just say, if you follow me on social media, Bonnie Ross and I had a little conversation on Twitter, and your boy is going to redeem himself at E3 2020. Bonnie Ross, Gamertag Radio, we're doing it, the redemption tour. I can't wait. It's going to be exciting.
You weren't nervous, right?
No, I was not nervous. I can't wait. And I'll just full disclosure on that. So yes, publicly we talked about it, and there were some offline conversations as well. 100% is going to happen. I'm going to get a chance to sit down with Bonnie Ross after they reveal Halo Infinite. And we just kind of, you know, obviously we'll joke around about the old interview, and then obviously we'll talk about whatever Halo Infinite is going to be and just the future Halo and all that good stuff. Should be, trust me, I'm super excited. It's going to be a fantastic conversation. But going back to Halo Infinite, I expect it to be some kind of open world. They're going to have some ongoing content. It'll be interesting, in my opinion. Again, we know the game is about Master Chief, so you're going to be playing as Master Chief, Cortana, and all that. But once you're done with that story, are we playing as another Spartan? And then that's when it kind of goes into the open world stuff. How is all that going to work? Obviously, the multiplayer component is going to be huge with Halo Infinite. How is all that going to go down? I'm excited to just see what the hell it's going to be. Because like I said it to Phil Spencer, I've said it all the time. This is the most important game they have ever made. They cannot screw this up. They cannot. This has to hit. It has to work, or it potentially could kill the franchise. And obviously Microsoft doesn't want that to happen. So I'm sure they got some of the smartest people on the planet working on this game. They're throwing all the money they need at it to make sure that everything works. It is fantastic at launch, which we assume will probably be November of this year.
Do you think it's going to be kind of similar to Destiny? Not the RPG part, but more of like working together, boss battles. And of course, they're going to be the multiplayer side, which, you know, Microsoft is going to invest so much on like esports from that side. But I'm talking about like more of the PvE side. Do you see that, Paris?
I'm expecting, and again, to just borrow from, you know, a previous studio that worked on it, I'm expecting some type of Destiny type element to this game as far as co-op goes. And, you know, not they're going to just cookie cutter call it a strike or a raid or things like that, but Halo Infinite has to have some kind of end game to it, and it has to have some kind of loot table to it that makes it interesting. So are they going to embrace more of the RPG side of Halo? We don't know. That's what's so fascinating about this. I have no idea. No idea what they're going to do with this. So E3, I'm trust me, and I'm convinced now. I'll say this right off the top. I'm convinced now. They're kicking the show off with Halo Infinite. I'm calling it now. That's my Miss Leo. They're kicking the show off with it. There's like, they're just gonna put all the cards on the table. Let's just get it going. Get everyone hype. Halo Infinite to start the show. That's what I think.
Yeah,